Nice. So these wheel cylinders have done somewhere between 50 and 60,000 miles over 6 years. Lots of it winter driving. I don't think they've done too bad, but yeah, they're all a bit manky. I've been meaning to get around to doing this for a while. I've had a number of problems with sticky cylinders at times, but no leaks until now. Brake fluid being hygroscopic, you get sort of accumulation of rust and so on in there. I do try and clean them out, but yeah, I think they've done their time. Hello folks, and welcome back to the workshop. You join me as I'm about to go and start on the next phase of restoration on the Land Rover. All the while it was in daily use, it was really just fixed up and, you know, kept on the road. It was impossible to really restore things properly, and now that I'm not using it every day, I'm at a stage where I can actually take 2 or 3 months if I want to do some fairly major work. Still outside, it's winter, it's about -2 with the wind chill today, so not very pleasant, but I need to get on with it, and then hopefully I can enjoy it next spring and summer. So back in the lockdowns, I made a fairly comprehensive list of all the things that I want to do, and you might remember that about 5 or 6 years ago I took the near side wing off and then I had to replace a footwell, but I restored everything on that side that I could get to, like the heater unit for example. So I'm going to do kind of the same thing on the off side. I'm going to take the steering box out and fit the one that I previously overhauled, and I'm going to overhaul the brakes, and that'll mean restoring the pedal towers, replacing master cylinders, all the brake slave cylinders, shoes, the lot. And there's quite a few brake lines that I want to change. Some of them are copper, some of them are still original. So I think now's a good time. So quite a comprehensive list of works, and I think it will take me into the spring. But today's task is just to remove the near side wing, and that will give me a start. So yeah, we'll see how we get on. Start. Actually it took about a minute of cranking. I think the modern fuel really goes off very quickly. It's been set about a month. Anyway, she started. So you can see the brake fluid reservoir. All this looks really kind of old. I've absolutely no idea how old the master is. The level was up here, and I noticed in about August that it had dropped, so I topped it up and kept an eye on it. And when that wheel cylinder failed, it dropped again. So actually, it's only lost a tiny amount of fluid, but it makes quite a mess. So you can see some of these brake pipes are original. Probably going to replace those. I expect they'll get destroyed trying to get those unions undone. But today's task, challenge, is to get the wing off, which will mean unclipping all the wiring, disconnecting the wiring to the front lights. Shouldn't be too difficult. I did a bit of a rewire when fitted the LED headlights. The fixing is down here. There's a row of bolts down here onto the front slam panel, which are going to be pretty unpleasant. But hopefully we can get the wing away complete with wiring. Mud flap will have to come off. And then there's a load of bolts all down here. One on the top. I've never had those out, so yeah, could be interesting.
So you can see way down in there the red battery cables. I've never been happy with the routing of them to my isolator switch. They're in danger of chafing on things, which is dangerous. And frankly, I can do better now. So I'm probably gonna run them down to the chassis if I can. Run them along low down. So that's one of the items to be attended to. So yeah, a bit of a before and after for you.
We'll have a look and see what it looks like when the job's done. So the mud shield's out. Might actually replace these with some galvanised ones, they're getting a bit rotten. I repaired these about 8 years ago. I think I told you the funny story about this one. The bottom half of that is the back of an office filing cabinet. I've often wondered if anyone's ever tried to move said filing cabinet. Amusingly, the filing cabinet material has survived very well. Some of the original is starting to rot. I really was on a budget when I started with this vehicle. I still am. But, you know, back then, 15 quid for a new mud shield was sometimes too much. So I think we might replace them. Clean all these bits up. Lots of new bolts required, I think. Well, I've just come in for a break from the cold for a minute, but I thought I'd just show you this. So I've had this socket set since I bought the Land Rover. I think I got it second hand just after I got that, and it's had an absolute caning working on that over the years. So I actually gave it a bit of restoration. Didn't bother knocking all the dents out of it, but treated all the rust. It was red rusty. Gave all the sockets a clean. I don't think I've ever done that, and it's come up nice. Even took the ratchet apart, so that should be good for another 10 years hopefully. Yeah, I don't think it was an expensive kit back in the day, but it's certainly a good one. So all the bolts down there are almost like an Acme thread, so they rarely get stuck. All of those came out okay. Even this bolt here came out. I've released the one for the trim there, and the sill and the mud flap. So the wing is almost free now. The wiring was pretty easily removed and I poked it right out of the way. Now that all the colours are correct after I did that rewire, save for this one for the fan, which I'm going to change during this work, it'll be easy to rewire it all, and I've gone back to all the old proper Lucas connectors, so that's easy. What hasn't been so easy is getting the bolts, if I can just turn you around, the bolts down here out. There should be a strip in there which has sort of captive bolts or studs on it, and someone obviously at some stage, probably during its army life, has replaced all of them with ordinary bolts, and they're a real swine to get at. So I'm having lots of fun trying to get those out. So I think there's about three more, then I can actually take the wing off. Second time lucky. I'd forgotten to remove that bolt there. I didn't even realise there was that one there, to be honest with you. Learn something new every time. Well, I really was expecting to find something in the way of rust repairs needed on this side, but it looks remarkably good. They usually go down here. Quite often you see them rust out between the wing. I think we'll, between the wing and the pillar, There's a little bit of rust going on here, so I think we'll clean all this up and give it a coat of paint. But I'm really pleased with how good that is. So I'm going to finish here for today. I think the next thing will be to strip off the brake master and pedal tower, and then we can look at the steering box. I decided taking the wing off and stripping the entire offside bulkhead would just be the easiest way to go about this job. Just do it all while I'm in the one place. So the plan is to restore everything this side and work my way down to the wheel brakes. So people always talk about Land Rovers being made of Bermabrite. A Land Rover of this era is not Bermabrite, it's just aluminium. So that's one of the reasons why mine is so battered. The main reason is that it had one former owner and about 100,000 drivers. But it hasn't fared too badly, and this wing can definitely be salvaged. But you can see why I have the checker plate tops on. So I've got to decide if I get some new wing tops and use the sides, or if I actually want to replace the wings at some stage. It's a working vehicle, I'm not too worried about it, but there's a little crack through there, so we need to put a reinforcing plate in there. Might be able to do a repair there as well. So there's various things we can do to improve it, because I think that fitting a new panel would look seriously out of place on this vehicle. So yeah, it's not a particularly nice Land Rover as they go. I'm just aiming for mechanical soundness. Also things like this here, you know, there's one of these little plate nuts missing, so we can replace that. Lots of improvements to be made. I think I mentioned in the update that I did a few weeks ago, a month or so ago, the fume curtain. Really warm in there with that. Shame I'm not going to actually get to enjoy the benefits of that now, but there it is. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. It's been so long since I've actually got to spend any time working on the Land Rover. It kind of reminded me why I do it, actually. And I can see in my mind's eye the improvement, how it's going to be when it's done, and I'm looking forward to that. So hopefully it won't be too long before I get to work on it again, and I can bring you another update and a bit more detail next time. So I guess next time we'll be taking the pedal tower off and the master cylinder. Anyway, yeah, hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you again very soon. Thanks for watching.